Welcome to Pure Hustle Podcast. I'm Mike.
And this is Orlando, and we're here for another Monday minisode.
That's right. Our Monday minis are the opportunity we have to talk about something that's interesting, unique, something we wanted to share with you regarding reselling, but we get to do it in a short amount of time. So we are Pure Hustle Podcast. So typically, our episodes are an hour plus every Wednesday, wherever you listen to podcasts or on YouTube. But our Monday minis are much shorter. It's a chance for us to kind of just quickly talk about something with these shortened attention spans. Sometimes it's nice just to get a quick tip here and there. And today we're talking about one that's really, really important, especially for a lot of new or beginner resellers. But even if you're a seasoned reseller, some of these might be very useful for you. And that is where to pick up free shipping supplies. And you can't beat free, especially when you're really trying to look at your bottom line and make as much profit as possible. So if we happen to miss any, let us know in the comments below. But I think we've got a lot of really interesting places where you can pick up free shipping supplies.
Yeah. And the reason I thought we should share this too is we've been doing a lot of, I call reselling tough, reselling philosophy, right? And I kind of got tired of that. I was like, let's give people some practical tips, right? Because we can talk all about why you should keep going and why you shouldn't quit. And it's, all those kind of conversations. But sometimes it's just good to just have information. And there's a comment I saw on Reddit that cracked me up because we're talking about free shipping supplies. But I wanted to share this comment before we get started. It says, you don't maintain, let alone up top rated seller status by sending your items in other people's trash. And I'm like, wait a second. So what this person is saying is if you use free supplies, you will lose top rated seller status or that it's going to count negative against you. I know.
Wait, read the quote one more time.
Okay. You don't maintain, let alone up top rated seller status by sending your items in other people's trash.
Yeah, that's an interesting one because both of us being top rated sellers, many people on our Discord being top rated sellers. I've never had anybody complain. I mean, I've had people complain every once in a while, like, oh, this wasn't packaged properly. And it's mostly because the post office ends up like throwing it out the back of their truck and running it over a couple of times before they end up shipping it. But yeah, I mean, there's probably a line you could draw where it's like, OK, this is like a junky box. It's like beat up to start with. And it's you're using just literal garbage. But I think we as resellers, we know that when we're using free stuff, we're not using stuff that looks like it's just nothing but trash. You're still trying to maintain some kind of a business. And I've never had anybody complain because they got their item in a box that was different than whatever the item, specifically, especially if it's an used item. Maybe this would be the case if you're like a new seller, you're selling like just new stuff. I can maybe see that, but definitely not. Let us know in the comments below. Have you ever had somebody complain because you ship something? I mean, I've shipped stuff in like diaper boxes, right? Yeah. Or things like that. I've never had anybody complain.
I did a Hot Pockets box once just to prove a point. Because there was a debate like a year ago that you shouldn't ship, should you ship stuff out in used food boxes? And I'm not saying you should. Like I don't. I'm actually right now I'm looking at a Subway sliced pepperoni box, which is a decent box, but will I use it to ship? Probably not. But if that's all you have, it just cover up stuff that bothers you. And obviously you can't ship stuff out in boxes that have alcohol labeling on it. That's actually against the law. But the reality is, yeah, like you said, I've never had anybody going like, oh, I can't believe you use this Amazon box to ship out an eBay package. Like that's never happened. Or, I can't believe that you use a Trader Joe's bag as packing material. Because, sometimes you get the paper bags from the grocery stores. And I've been short back in the day the paper packaging. And I've used it. And I've never had somebody say, oh, I can't believe you use this Trader Joe's bag, to make sure my item arrives safely. So I want to encourage all of you. Now, I also want to say it's not a flex to be like, oh, I buy all my supplies brand new. Like, come on. Like if you have to flex that, then there's something you need. I don't know. Maybe you need therapy or something like that. That's not like a big deal. Like no one cares. Because I've actually heard and I've seen it too on Reddit forums and so on. Like if you don't pay for all your shipping supplies, you're not serious about reselling. And I'm like, yeah, I don't know about that. I know plenty of sellers that are six-figure sellers, high six-figure sellers, that, yeah, they buy a lot of their supplies, but if they have an opportunity to get 30 or 40 free boxes or a bunch of pack material for free, they're going to do it because it's going to help their bottom line. So, all right, why don't we get started here?
Let's do it. So what's the first place somebody should go if they're looking to get free stuff?
I would say go to USPS and UPS. Now, this isn't going to be a how-to. I don't want to spend the time doing the how-to, but it's real simple. USPS gives you free priority boxes. They have to be used for priority. And then free flat rate priority boxes. Now, the priority boxes, you can modify them. As long as you ship priority, you can modify them. The flat rate boxes, you can't modify. You used to be able to back in the day, and then USPS changed that. So that's one way. You could also go to the UPS site, and you got to make a UPS account, and you do have to ship stuff via UPS, but you don't have to do it through their website. And you're actually able to get a lot of free actual craft brown boxes, and they're great. And so those are available to you for free. Obviously, you know, there's always going to be that guy that's going to put in the comments like, don't use these illegally. Don't turn them inside out. Like, don't, you know. Well, listen, we're all responsible adults here. So I'm not going to go into that rant, but it's there. So go to the USPS store online. Go to free priority supplies, and they'll even ship it to you for free. UPS also will ship it to you for free. So that's the easy one. And I'll just jump on the next one real quick. Part of that is free priority tape. Now, this gets a little bit more complicated. I can go to my local branch and I can ask for free priority tape if they have it, because I've established a relationship with them. They'll give it to me right there. A lot of post offices will say, hey, here's a number, or there's a number to call. I don't recall the number right now. I just didn't want to just blast it on here, but you can YouTube it. There's plenty of people out there that have given the number. You call, tell them, you know, what you're going to use it for. They'll make you answer some questions like, understand this is only for priority, this is only for United States Post Office, but you can get some free priority tape that way.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, the next couple kind of are ones that I've used quite a bit, especially early on in my reselling. I don't use it quite as much now because, not flexing, but I do purchase more just for sake of ease of time. My time a lot of times is more valuable. But one of the things you can do is local businesses. A lot of these places, if you've ever been to, like, let's say a Walmart, or you've been at the Dollar Tree or something like that, when they're stocking shelves and you see a lot of times they've got like just boxes and they're just thrown in a pile, those all go into the back and they all just get smashed and sent away somewhere. I definitely wouldn't ask every time unless you're really desperate for boxes. But if you're walking through and you see like, hey, they've got like these boxes that they're using here is like a perfect size for these items I sell a lot of. I've asked multiple times. I've never had anybody say no. A couple times, if it's like a new like worker, they might say, I don't know, let me ask my manager. And if it's not a big deal, I might not wait around. But a lot of times, they're like, yeah, sure. And you could grab, you know, snag 5-10 boxes that are a good size of something you need. Or the other thing is even just checking out at the dumpster behind these places. Now, again, it's probably best to talk to them ahead of time. Where I used to work, there was like a cafe kind of attached to it. And I talked to somebody there, like, hey, you guys throw a lot of boxes out into the back there. Would it be hard if I went through those every so often? And they're like, yeah, sure. So you probably don't want to be caught in the dumpster of a business. Now, there's whole dumpster diver stuff. I'm not saying that you shouldn't do that, but that's probably, you're running bigger risk, especially if you're just grabbing boxes. You know,
it depends on the city, too.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, some places you might be actually committing a crime. But, you know, if you ask somebody like, hey, like, would you mind if I check? You got a lot of boxes back there. If I grab some boxes, most people, I mean, so many people I've talked to, they get it even just from like if they're moving. Right. Like how many friends have you had where like they're moving? Like, hey, if you have boxes saved. So most people can recognize like, hey, somebody needs boxes. Yeah, no, of course. Sure. Take boxes. So that's definitely something you can ask for. And when it comes to packing material, this one is maybe a little bit outside of the box of what you might consider. But my dad used to work at a newspaper. He worked at the local newspaper growing up. My whole life, he was a pressman. And so he actually worked in the part of the newspaper place that printed the newspapers. He would operate a forklift and put these giant rolls. At the time, they'd be huge rolls of paper. And by the time they would get to where there would be like just a little bit left on the roll, which was still a lot of paper, but how fast those machines would run, they would have to splice off and put a new roll on and keep the machine rolling. And so they had to do that on the fly. So there was always waste. There would be sometimes, you know, several inches of paper left on a roll because if it went another 30 seconds, that might be gone. So these guys would just toss these out into the bin. Sometimes they'd recycle them. People would come and buy them from them. And so every newspaper place is going to be different. But if there's a place around you locally that's printing, even like those advertisement type papers, newspapers, it doesn't hurt to go by and ask them like, hey, do you either sell or give away the I think they were called stubs. That's what they called them. Because, yeah, you might be able to get enough paper to wrap your stuff for the next year for $20. My dad said they'd sell them for $5, $10 all the time. So something to consider is just checking out your local newspaper place to either get really inexpensive or free. They might say, yeah, sure, just take a whole roll of one of these.
I actually had, the small town I used to live in, they had a newspaper, and obviously I don't think a lot of people read it. So they always had tons of extra copies. So they didn't have the subs, but they would always say, yeah, take all the newspapers you want. So I'd have like 100 newspapers would just use.
My trick for that is if you are going to use paper that's already been printed on,
okay,
just put the item in like a paper bag or wrap it in plastic first. So put it in a plastic bag. Like if you're going to ship shoes, for instance, or something like that, or anything really, put it inside of, I use the little clear trash bags that you can get. Like I buy hundreds of them or Costco. Like thousands. Yeah. You just really cheap, inexpensive, small, like 10 gallon, whatever they are, trash bags that are clear. Wrap your item in that first and then put the newspaper around it because you don't want the ink from the newspaper to get on those really nice white shoes that somebody's getting or that sweater or whatever it is. Maybe they're getting a coffee cup and you don't want that ink to smear on there. So whatever it is, if you're going to use print, something that already has ink on it, I would put it in plastic first.
Yeah, agreed. No, that's a great tip. I just remember, I also clipped all the coupons out too. This was back in the day, All right. Hey, also though, on top of that, there's so much free stuff out there as far as moving boxes, packing supplies. Sometimes you can get even tape. It's wild. And that's just on your local marketplaces, right? We've talked a lot about sourcing, from Facebook Marketplace or OfferUp, but you can also get a lot of shipping supplies. And it's funny because somebody in our Discord actually said people are now trying to sell it. So you might come across that sometimes, but maybe you'll get a good, great deal. Who knows? But I will tell you, Facebook Marketplace, just do a safe search for, moving boxes or packing supplies. You can go to OfferUp. You can go Craigslist. The Nextdoor app's a great tool too. Back in the day, I remember OfferUp. I'm not OfferUp, sorry. Nextdoor. I used to get a ton of free shipping materials. And it's basically your neighborhood community. And so once they know who you are and they know that you want that, that's a great way to network and then kind of, share your info if you feel comfortable. And eventually you don't even have to go to the app. They'll just directly contact you and say, hey, I ordered, 20 packages in the last month. I kept all the boxes for you. They're here for you. So definitely use your marketplace. Now, this next one I want to share here, I kind of struggle with this because this is my go-to. This is easy. And so I hope I'm not creating competition for myself here, but I don't know if have you ever picked up free shipping supplies from U-Haul?
I haven't. Okay. I know sometimes they have those boxes out front, like the stuff in it.
Yeah. So, I mean, this does not require a ski mask or anything. Okay. So you just, you go in and there's actually a section where people, when they're done moving and they don't use materials, they just put it in this huge container. And you find these at most U-Haul stores. For example, this last time I picked up, no joke, 20 10x8x6 boxes. I picked up a whole thing of packaging paper that cost $13 that wasn't even used. They just threw it in there. And I remember going to the employee. I'm like, hey, if for real, I can take this. Yeah, it was in there. I'm like, all right, that's fine. And, then I picked up a whole bunch of other packing paper, bubble wrap galore sometimes I'll find in there. And so, you never know what you'll find. I have one locally, so I go probably every other day. They know me very well, so they've even said, if there's a huge amount, we'll just text you and let you know so you don't miss out. And so, I got a leg up on my competition. But it's been amazing. There was a time where I bought zero boxes and zero packing supplies, probably for, I want to say, at least a year and a half. because I just kept going over and just picking up. And it was great. So definitely check it out. Again, it depends, you know, where you live. Maybe in your state it's different, but I know around here I've been able to find consistent good boxes, great packing paper, some of the stuff not being used.
Yeah, that's good. And one that we've talked about a lot, but this is it is so underrated, and I think a lot of people are afraid to share with others. Mm-hmm. But especially if you're a part-time reseller, you've got a community of some kind, maybe it's church community, maybe it's just friends in your neighborhood, don't be afraid to tell people you're a reseller, because people are interested, they want to know. And then one of the things you can ask for is, hey, if you get some Amazon boxes, would you mind saving them for me? Or if you get those bubble pillows, like fill them up, like a big trash can bag full mm-hmm. of them, I'll come pick them up from you if you are willing to do that. So many people are willing to help, because again, a lot of times people know this stuff is just going in the trash. So the two options they have is it goes in the trash or the recycle, if they are, you know, lucky enough to live somewhere that has recycling cans, or they know to themselves, like, this isn't just going in a recycling can, but I know it's going to somebody who's actually going to use it, right? And there's a lot of people who want to help you just because people want to help a lot of times. And two, they also feel like they're doing something for, like, the environment. They're not just throwing stuff in the trash. Something is getting reused. So you'll be surprised if you let a few people know that, you know, hey, save your air pillows for me, save your boxes for me. If they're about this size, you can't give them a few, you know, parameters, so you're not getting, you know, things that you would never use. But you'd be surprised, a handful of people knowing that, you might not ever have to buy shipping stuff again, right? You might have more than you know what to do with, and then you have the awkward, like, okay, I can't take any more, stop for a while, but then I'll let you know when I need more, you know, because yeah, sometimes it's worth just, like, piling up, because those connections, once you have them, it's great. So don't be afraid to network. Don't be afraid to tell people you resell, and just ask for the boxes, because you'd be surprised. It's people love to help with that stuff.
And the larger of a workplace that, you know, you work, the more options you'll have, as far as there could be a lot more people that will bring you boxes. And yeah, it's, I mean, we've shared this story so many times, but when I was still in education and Mike and I were, you know, working at the same place, Mike wasn't reselling at that time, but I was reselling, and I communicated, Mike would bring me boxes and a bunch of people would bring me boxes outside of my office. It was kind of, I think back now, that must have been kind of odd, being a school administrator and there's all these Amazon boxes outside my office. But yeah, it saved me so much money. And listen, all these tips that we've given everyone, like, if you're part-time, like, this is definitely should be your go-to, right? Because you're not consistently, like, every day having, you know, 20, 30, 40, 50 sales. But even if you are full-time, right, and right now, you know, every dollar that you're saving is a dollar that you can use to go sourcing instead of going towards your supplies. And yeah, you may be able to claim it, you know, on your taxes, but you're never going to get the full amount back. So why not try to exhaust avenues where you can get these items for free and keep yourself profitable? With that being said, make sure to be real,
be relevant,
and be reselling. Leads.
Peace.